Shalom.
Shalom. It's a blessing to be out here tonight. We look forward to fellowship with everyone later on, but as we know, this is the Pesach, and Heavenly Father requires that we all make this festive journey. Where are we coming from? Heavenly Father requires 3 times out of the year that we make a pilgrimage, all right, to keep his names, to keep his particular holy names. So as of right now, we're going to go over the book of Exodus, the 12th chapter, and we're going to read 2 verses out of it. Starting with the 10th verse.
Exodus 12:11. And thus shall ye eat it, with your loins girded, and your shoes on your feet, and your staff in your hand.
And Heavenly Father required that we was to have our loins girded. Now this particular reference is talking about the men. Because we got to keep in mind, when we watch a lot of these television shows and these documentaries, you got to kind of do things in reverse and look at it from a Hebrew mind. Alright? But what Esau shows us, you see elderly men with canes and staffs. But we got to look at it like this. We was coming out of Egypt. Look at how Moses moved. Moses killed the man. So Moses wasn't no soft guy. He was trained. Look where he was at. He was in Pharaoh's household. So you would say that he was the only Israelite that was trained. So brothers had staffs. It was easy to gather. It was, they didn't have the opportunity to go out there and melt metal to make swords. But they was able to get branches and pieces of wood, and those pieces of wood was there that brothers utilized in time of defense because we was making a journey out of Egypt. So we was eating in haste. So if we was eating in haste, that means that it was a lot of turmoil and death around us. Alright? So that's why we are supposed to, according to law, when we eat the Pesach, have our loins girded, going back to Solomon, men dressed in warlike apparel. So when we eat the Passover, we're supposed to have our staffs in our hands, our loins girded, shoes on our...
And verse 11. And thus shall you eat it, with your loins girded, your shoes on your feet, and your staffs in your hand. And you shall eat it...
It's the Mosai's Passover. So again, when we were in Egypt, this like this time period, it was wartime. As you read the scriptures and you see as times progress, certain things was instituted, like the Yayan. This being read about Yayan in Exodus 12 chapter, didn't we? Did anybody read about Yayan? Oh, wine. You didn't read about wine in Exodus 12 chapter, so why is wine in it? Now, so we gotta look at things as times moved on, things became a progression. It's just like style. The shoes you wear is an upgrade, right? Back in the days, you wore tight pants because that's what brothers had, knees. Now the time for breasts. The styles change, all right? So that, it went back in time, which is totally, that's all. So, you know, when we look at Esdras and the Apocrypha, we see an elevation that took place when we was under those righteous kings. All right, and how the Heavenly Father set it up and put the vibration on these men to sacrifice large amounts of land and the celebration aspects of it. All right, so we're in that celebration mode, but we also in the wartime because we know based on the time period that we live in, we'll be in that season. All right, so we're rehearsing the righteous acts, and with that, brothers, just want to say shalom.
Shalom.
First Corinthians, the 11th chapter. Chapter, we're going to start with 18 verse. I kind of want to just touch base on and elaborate on what Elder Matthias had just brought out earlier on. And he made reference to people eating the Passover unworthily, where they would come for the first day, not come back around for the seventh day in regards to the feast of unleavened bread. Or people making sure their spirit wasn't right. Okay? So we're going to start with the 18th verse. This is 1 Corinthians. 11th chapter and the 18th verse, it reads, "For first of all, when ye come together in the church, I hear that there be divisions among you, and I partly believe it." See, a lot of people don't understand exactly what this is referring to. But Paul, and when he wrote this letter to the church of Corinth, they knew exactly what he was referencing. The divisions that was happening was in regards to the breaking of bread and the Lord's Passover. We're about to find out. He's going to elaborate. Go ahead. Verse 19, "For there must be also heresies among you, that they which are approved may be made manifest among you." Verse 20, "When ye come together therefore into one place, this is not to eat the Lord's Supper." 21, wait a minute, let me grab that. It said this is not to eat the Lord's Supper. First of all, there's only one time in Scripture when you're going to hear that term, that phrase, ology, the Lord's Supper. Okay, and what Paul is bringing out right now is you have a lot of brothers and some sisters. They show up for the whole purpose of just eating to be fed. When we read this thing in context, as we're about to do, you're going to see exactly what Paul is referring to. You only showed up for that reason. You didn't show up for the memorial. Just like you see today in the Christian church. Some people don't go to church none the whole year, but when Easter comes, they go there. They're not even really going there. They're going out there to celebrate, to show out, with the new garments on, to eat the food, but it's not in sincerity of the lesson. So y'all know that. Y'all see that. Pass that along to your family members. Remember the scripture that the brother is bringing out and show them this when you get home. Because like options brought out, you have people that ain't been to church all year, but they show up for Easter. They want to look their best. They're there for the meal, and you're not going to see them next Sunday. They're going to be there 5 Sundays after that, okay? And like brothers brought out, don't make the Passover your Easter.
Exactly.
Right. Don't use this opportunity for a moment in time to say, you know what, I'm going to get together with the Akim. Everybody got fresh garments, you know, and we about to eat this lamb. I probably can't afford it on my own 9 times out of 10, but we're going to come together for this supper.
That's right.
That's right. Go ahead. Verse 21. "For in eating every one taken before other his own supper." This is how you know he's referring to. You've been inconsiderate. They're being inconsiderate. So he's addressing the issues that specific church was having. There was no consideration for their brethren. Go ahead. "And one is hungry and another is drunken." Mm-hmm. You know that's Israel. That's Israel. Verse 22. "What? Have ye not houses to eat and to drink in?" Why did you show up to the Passover just so we can eat to full and drink to you tipsy? Don't you have a home where you can do that at? This is what Paul is asking. Don't you have a home? But when we gather together, we do this as a memorial and remembrance. This is an ordinance for the nation of Israel. Okay? Go ahead. For despise ye the church of Yahweh, and shame them that have not? What shall I say to you? Shall I praise you in this? I praise you not. Paul said, you know what, you get no kudos, no accolades, or nothing for that type of activity. Only thing you get is open the roof. Go ahead. For I received from the Most High that which also I delivered unto you, that the Mashiach Yahawashah, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. Verse 24. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat. This is my body which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. See, this goes back to what happened in 1 Corinthians 11 and 1. Paul said, be he follows me, as I also am of Christ. Right? Huh? So what you have to understand is what he's referencing right here is exactly what the Mashiach said. Real quick, go to Luke 22. Luke chapter 22. 19. This is Luke chapter 22, verse 19. And he took bread and gave thanks and brake it and gave unto them, saying, this is my body which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me. Verse 20. Likewise also the cup after supper, saying, this cup is the new testament in my blood, which is shed for you. So clearly, like, see, in the church they try to tell Israel, or so-called blacks and Hispanics, that Paul came to rearrange things. Paul's clearly following in the steps of the Mashiach and quoted them. This is exactly what's going on right here. This is what we're doing to us in the glory. Okay? The same way in ancient Egypt, they had that whole thing with the lamb and the blood. This is what we're getting ready to engage in this evening. Okay? This food in remembrance of the Lamb of God and the blood that was shed for the remission of sins for the nation of Israel. We all? Verse 21. But behold, the hand of him that betrayed me is with me on the table. And truly the Son of Man goeth as it was determined. Verse 25. This is Luke 22, of 1 Corinthians 11, verse 25. After the same manner also he took the cup when he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me. 26. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Most High death till he come. So, again, it's a memorial. Okay? We're acknowledging what happened. We're acknowledging the sacrifice that was made. We're acknowledging the blood that was shed. And we do this throughout our generations forever. The same way just like we just read in the book of Exodus. This is a law for the nation of Israel to be kept throughout our generations. Okay? This is not just for 2018. And we're still here in 2019. Then guess what? The Passover, the Feast of Unleavened Bread is to be observed in its entirety for the Lent. Right? Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of Yahawashah unworthily shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Mashiach Yahawashah. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily, eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning Hamashiach Yahushua's body. So this is why it's so important. Because you can ultimately eat and drink damnation to yourself. See, in the Christian church, when they give you a little bit of cup of grape juice and a little wafer, they'll explain the severity of observing the Lord's Passover. That's why you have, you know, the choir director doing this thing, pastor, poor child doing this thing, and everybody else engaged in all matters of folly. But in the end, they all point to be blessed. But yet, they wonder why they catch a hell. Why? Because they even drank damnation unto themselves, because they didn't discern what they had going on, according to as it is written. And that's why you must examine yourself as you sit here right now, doing this Passover, doing this Feast of Unleavened Bread. Don't allow anybody to change your mind as far as the importance of this. Okay? Because what you gotta understand is that the glory days that's outlined in Leviticus 23rd chapter are displayed and observed in the so-called New Testament. We see in Acts 20th chapter when Paul was speaking with the disciples and they were making a transition from here to there. Matter of fact, at that point, we Acts chapter 20. God, I got you. Acts 20. This is the book of Acts, the 20th chapter, the 5th verse. These going before tarried for us at Troas. And we sailed away from Philippi after the days of unleavened bread and came unto them to Troas in 5 days, where we abode 7 days. This right here also is a cut to show you that the Feast of Unleavened Bread was observed outside of Jerusalem. This is the red cut. Read that verse one more time, King. And we sailed away from Philippi after the days of unleavened bread and came unto them to Troas in 5 days, where we abode 7 days. And upon the first day of the week, when the disciples came to gather to break bread, Paul preached unto them, ready to depart on the morrow, and continue his speech until midnight. So, at the end of the day, the Passover and the Feast of Unleavened Bread is to be observed throughout our generations. It did die at the cross. It wasn't nailed to the cross. Okay, it didn't go down into the tomb with the Mashiach. All right, we see evidence of this by the disciples and the apostles after the Mashiach ascended unto the right hand of the Father. God.
Everybody, turn to Mark the 14th chapter. Mark the 14th chapter is a very important chapter. And the reason why it's a very important chapter, because it's honoring a great sister of the nation. All right, people, when they look at us, the first thing they say, where's the women at? Why don't the women come out here and teach? Y'all hate women. Y'all disrespectful towards women. But when you read it, in our reality, why would you want your woman at the forefront of the spiritual war? Think about it. See, the white man, he wants his woman to fight his wars, but he's the coward. Why would we want our women on that forefront? You understand? See, the problem is the world is just mad because our women are in the spirit of Yahushua. And they let the men lead.
That's
why they're upset. And what we're about to do is read about one of our great sisters and the works that she done for our Hamashiach Yahushua. Okay, so everybody start at Mark the 14th chapter, and we're going to start at the first verse.
It's the book of Mark, the 14th chapter, in the first verse. After 2 days was the feast of Passover, and the unleavened bread. And the chief priests and scribes saw how they might take him by craft and put him to death. But they said, not on the feast day, lest there be an uproar of the people.
So the chief priests and the scribes, they were crafty. And this shows you that they were committing premeditated murder. This is premeditated murder. So they're guilty. The same way that they killed the prophets, these are their children, killing the Hamashiach and Yahushua. It's premeditated from the beginning to the end. And they premeditated to kill them because they didn't want to lose their spot in power. Read on.
And being in Bethany in the house of Simon the leper, as he sat at meat, there came a woman having an alabaster box of ointments, spikenard, very precious, and she broke the box and poured it on his head.
Right, this woman, when you go into the other Gospels, you know it's Mary of Bethany. You'll know who this woman is, so we're not going to have to jump all around. Just read on your own precepts. Read on.
And there were some that had indignation within themselves and said, why was this waste of the ointment made? For it might have been sold for more than 300 pence and have been given to the poor.
See, and the person that had the problem with Judas Iscariot. And it wasn't even about, if you know about spikenard, it's a very precious ointment. The problem was, he wasn't in the spirit anyway. Because there was nothing that she was doing wrong by doing what she was doing. But he wasn't in the spirit anyway because
this is the one that betrayed Christ. Move on. And they murmured against her. And Yehoshua said, let her alone. Why trouble ye her? She has brought a good work on me.
And we know in all the Gospels that I let you know it was Judas Iscariot. He was the one that was troubled. His spirit was already gone. Because he had betrayed the Messiah.
So read on. For ye have the poor with you always, and whensoever ye will may do them good. But me, ye have not always.
Right, so Christ understood, because he understood who he was talking to. He's talking to the person that set him up. So he's like, look, the poor is always going to be with you. Christ understands his time is coming now. He's like, but me, I'm not going to be here too much longer. So you can always take care of the poor, but you're always going to remember my words. This is what he's saying.
Read on. She had done what she could. She has come aforehand to anoint my body to the burial.
Right, so what she's doing is she understood. This is how much Mary of Bethany was in the spirit. She understood he was going to die. She understood what was going on. So this is what she did. So she was anointing his body, getting it ready for him to be put to death and be buried. Read on.
Verily I say unto you, wheresoever this gospel shall be preached throughout the world, throughout the whole world, this also that she have done shall be spoken for her, of a memorial of her.
So we are commanded to remember our virtuous righteous sisters, like Mary of Bethany, like you sisters. This is the type of women that you should pattern yourselves after. A woman who served to have a shot until his death. So there are a lot of great women in the scriptures, like Judas. So this is something we need to think about.
Listen, everybody, listen up. Shema, everybody. If you're not serving food, I need you to go back to your seat. In the back, Israel. If you're not serving food, we need you to go back to your seat, because we're trying to figure out, there's still people coming in, and we don't know what seats are taken or what seats are not taken. All right, so the facility's asking, we're not allowed to take any more chairs from anywhere. We're at capacity. So we want to know what chairs are still open. If you're not serving food, please go to your seat. Please. There's people coming in that's looking for seats. So we need to know what seats are open. If there's a seat at your table, let people know so that somebody can come and sit at your table. All right, we're at capacity. The Maccabees Alliance, we already outgrew this place. So next year, we got to be someplace bigger. You see that, right, Ash? You got to be someplace good. All praise to the Lord's offer that. All praise to the Lord's
Thank you.
Also, Mr. Ross, remind brothers and sisters, no drink is to leave this room. Not outside, not by your cars, no drink is to leave this room. And you know what we've been talking about.
I just want to say too, while we're getting everything together, man, this is a beautiful thing. Y'all make sure that y'all film this. Get you taking cameras out of everybody's screen, like Mr. Daniel said. This is our first year of the Black Panther Lions Council doing Passover every week, and we'll be up in some passes. So this is an excellent turnout, a beautiful turnout. And you know, take it serious, because you know, these last days, man, Amashiach the House is definitely approaching. And just like we went through this angel and this exodus out of Egypt, we want to do that same thing here and the same similarities of what took place in Egypt, in ancient Egypt, we're going to see today in spiritual Egypt. So this ain't no game, this ain't no playtime, this walk is serious. This is a serious walk, and take it as a serious walk, because your life depends on it. So brothers, if you are not a part of the service, please, let's be respectful, and let's keep the noise down to a minimum. Let's be respectful, please, and we are still in service. We will be fellowshipping afterwards, but let's keep the level of noise down.
Their brother, the man standing, they're not doing security, tell them to come up front.
Come. Everybody turn to 1 Corinthians 11, 1 Corinthians chapter 11. And verse 23. What letter might read? There's a book of 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that of Mashiach Yahawashah, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he break it. Everybody take your little bread. Everybody take your little bread. Repeat after me. The water, the water that you're hungry.
The water, the water that you're hungry.
And when he had given thanks, he break it and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. After the same manner also, he took the cup when he had supped, saying,
if I take the water, drink.
This cup is a New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread, and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord.
It's been said several times already today. We're dealing with something very serious, y'all. Be serious about this. Okay?
But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily, eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body.
Come on. Hallelujah. How's everybody feeling?